Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. If you've ever participated in an ICO, you've probably heard of gas. When people speak of gas, they either mean the gas limit or the gas price. Both are an integral part of Ethereum. If you are not familiar with these two concepts, this video is for you. We will talk about the background and the use cases and tell you how to save on transaction fees. As you might know, Ethereum is a blockchain. This blockchain is decentralized and secured by miners. Ethereum is special for offering the execution of smart contracts. Each smart contract is written in Solidity, the programming language of Ethereum. To the computer, such a smart contract consists of opcodes. Opcode stands for operational code. Add is an opcode and stands for adding a number to another. Each opcode uses a specified amount of computational power. Gas is the unit of computational power. The Ethereum yellow paper specifies how much gas each opcode needs. The add operation needs 3 gas, for example. A multiplication, MUL, needs 5 gas. Question is, why don't we just specify the price per opcode? Why have this gas limit? That is to keep the transaction cost independent from the volatile price of Ethereum. To do that, there is also a gas price. The price is paid in Ether. However, it is a very small amount, so we use the Gwei. Gwei is based on the unit of Wei. This is the smallest amount in Ether available. It is not further divisible. This is the amount of Wei that equals 1 Ether. 1 Gwei is 1 billion Wei. Okay, so we have a gas price in Gwei. This price fluctuates, so it stays rather stable in relation to fiat. Currently, a normal gas price is 5.8 Gwei. What does this particularly look like? When you send Ether from an exchange, you won't have to deal with this. The exchange takes a fixed fee from you. In return, they decide on the gas limit and the gas price. Only if you send from your own wallet, you get to decide. The questions that the miners are asking the sender is basically this: how much computing power do you need? This is indicated by the gas limit. And how much do you pay per unit of computing power? This is indicated by the gas price. For a normal Ether transaction, the default gas is limited to 21,000. At a gas price of 5.8 Gwei, this currently translates to 3 cents. Transactions are not free, but very cheap. For other smart contracts, the gas needed can be tricky to estimate because it might depend on the exact calculations. If a contract is a loop that counts up to a random number, for example, then the number of loops performed is different every time. Thus, the number of opcodes differs. That is why you can always put a higher gas limit. You will only pay for what your operation uses. Once set, the gas price is what you will pay for every unit of gas used. Miners try to make money from their operations. Thus, they prefer operations with high gas price. The gas limit matters because every block has a gas limit. The limit expands when necessary. But for now, let's just keep in mind there is a limit. So, miners try to stuff as many operations as possible in a block. Of course, they take the ones that pay the most. So again, the gas limit says how many operations you want to maximally run. The gas price says how much you pay for each operation. If your contract needs more gas than your limit, it will cancel. In this case, you'd still have to pay for the resources used so far. But if miners reject your transaction because you pay too little, then it gets canceled and you don't pay anything. For an ICO, the gas limit is much higher. Most of them recommend 200,000. This is because ICO smart contracts are very intense. To run this task, miners need to use a lot of computational resources. Remember that this high gas limit does not speed up the transactions. If you want to be fast, you must use a high gas price. So, how can you save money? Let's say you want to transact on the Ethereum blockchain. For a simple transaction, you need a gas limit of 21,000. This cannot be changed, it just takes this much computing power. But you can change the gas price. If you choose 20 Gwei, your transaction will execute quickly. Here's the trick. If your transaction is not urgent, you can choose a lower gas limit. If you take 1 Gwei, then you pay 95% less. It might take an hour to execute them. Let's recap before time runs out. The gas limit is a limit on the number of operations you want. The gas price is the price you pay for each operation. A higher gas price makes your transactions execute faster. Miners prioritize transactions with high gas prices. Overall, sending a token like Agar on the Ethereum blockchain costs 3 cents currently. Thank you for watching. Before you go, please know that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy, sell any securities, coins, or tokens. I hope you liked this video and found it useful. Make sure to hit the like button and check out our other videos in the future on Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing.